Welcome back to the Atlanta Falcons franchise, everyone. I'm your host, Husker Eurocat, and today we bring you another cross-conference showdown with the AFC North. The Pittsburgh Steelers have come to Mercedes-Benz Stadium. While the Falcons will have their hands full with the Steelers that have started out the season with a 4-1 record, they have really big news out of the head office this past week. We knew that there might be big changes to the Falcon defense with their switch to a 4-3 alignment, and here it is. Foye Oluokun has been traded to the Buffalo Bills. It made it really easy, since after the preseason, a trade was made for Tremaine Edmonds, and now the Bills were in need of a middle linebacker. What was surprising is that they were willing to part with younger talent in defensive tackle Ed Oliver. And what was more, Atlanta got him and a fourth round pick as well. I think it will be really interesting for the Falcons because both Oliver and Edmonds are renewing their contracts after this season. Both are coming off rookie contracts, and I'm sure will command big money to stay in Atlanta. This could get ugly for the Falcons come this next offseason. For today, though, how is that trade going to affect the defense against the number one offense in the NFL? Let's watch things unfold as we get set for the Steelers and Falcons here on the MMC Broadcasting Network. John Ross is back deep for the Falcons, and Zane Gonzalez gets us underway here in Atlanta. Ross takes a knee, so it comes out to the 25. And there the Falcons will start. Corral gets sacked. The very first play, TJ Watt on the sack. And I would expect a lot of that in this game today because TJ Watt is only one of the defensive linemen that Pittsburgh has that is very, very good. Cameron Hayward and Trayvon Walker from Georgia was drafted by the Steelers, and that is going to be really tough for the Falcons to overcome. They go three and out, so the Steelers now with the ball. Remember, Najee Harris is not in this game. He is injured, so that was Snell, and a incomplete pass thrown over the middle, and Godwin can't hang on. Now, first and 10, and Bryce Love is tackled after only a 1 yard pickup. Enjoyed a 92 yard effort last week. So on third down, Corral back to pass, completes this one to Pitts, and he rolls over the top of the defender to get the first down. The pass complete out to Ely, and he's run out of bounds after a 4 yard pickup. So second and 6, and he has the first down over the right side. From the 39, Corral in the shotgun, throws short, and Love goes out of bounds. Not sure why he did that. He could have had a few more yards, and that one is complete over the middle to Pitts and picks up another first down. From the 49, second and 10, Ely is dropped in the backfield. Devin Bush getting to him for a 3 yard loss. So now on third and 13, Corral over the middle, can't find his intended target, and they have to punt. Stonehouse sends it on its way, and it's out of bounds at the 6. So with Pickett standing at the 1, gives off to Snell, and he has big yardage up the middle all the way out to the 26. The offensive line open up a hole, and he took advantage of that. Pickett throws deep on 39, and Godwin again with the drop, and Pinion sends it on its way. Ball is fielded by Ross at the 25, and he's out to the 39. A 14-yard return, but the Falcons can't do anything with it. And a nice punt by Stonehouse backs up the Steelers inside the 10-yard line. So now from the 7, Pickett is sacked in the end zone. Safety, Tremaine Edmonds. Pickett couldn't find anybody, and Edmonds comes off the edge and makes the sack. And once again, the Falcons can't do anything with it. So the Steelers have the ball again on 3rd and 3. The ball is complete over the middle. Freiermuth has the first down at the 37. Now Pickett throws over the middle, and that one is complete, and another first down. Kevin Rader making the snag, and Pickett so far is making good use of his tight ends. The throw is complete on the left side. Godwin makes the grab for the first down, and it's the end of the first quarter. 2-0 is your score. Snell up the middle and gets inside the 20. So the Steelers now in the red zone. That is complete down at the 5-yard line. Deontay Johnson with the first down. Now Pickett back to pass. Throws it out of the back of the end zone. So it's 3rd and goal. Back to pass. Pickett takes too long to find somebody, and Anthony Walker Jr. is there, makes the sack at the 14. Gonzalez comes on for a 31-yard field goal, and it's up and good. The Steelers take the lead 3-2. And here in the top of the third, the Falcons have the ball, and a play-action pass all day. Corral can't find anybody open and is tackled at the 30-yard line by T.J. Watt. His second sack of the day. So from the 24, the pass is complete out to Godwin. He's just shy of the sticks. And after a false start penalty, it's 3rd and 5. Pickett finds Juju Smith-Schuster. He has the first down from the 42 now. 1st and 5 after an offside penalty. He is sacked yet again. Derek Barnett gets in on the sack. So 2nd and 18, Pickett throws complete to Smith-Schuster, and he is well shy of the first down marker. So 3rd and 14 now. That one's complete over the middle to Freiermuth, but he had 6 yards to go, and another punt upcoming. Pinion has it. Drop at the 10, and it is downed inside the 5. So from the 4-yard line, the pitch back to Love, and he's tackled in the end zone. A safety on the other end. Devin Bush with the tackle in the end zone, and that takes us to 5-2. The defense is really shining in this one. And another sack, Tremaine Edmonds with 2 now as Pickett goes down in 3rd and 18. Pickett scanning the field, throws short, and Snell gets the first down. The Falcon defense completely baffled on that play. And a first down at the 45 is the result. Second and 11. Pickett can't find anybody open, and Anthony Walker gets to him for a second time. And now on third and 19, out of the shotgun, Pickett looking, and is dropped again. This time, Rashawn Evans gets to him in the backfield. Ross fields it at his own 26. Ooh, a nice move out past the 40-yard line. And more evidence of why the Falcons made the switch. Just moves like that that Ely didn't have, and Ross does. Love takes it over the left side and out of bounds, but not before getting another first down, which brings us down to the two-minute warning. Out of the shotgun, second and 10. The pass complete to Ely, and his foot touches the sideline. So third and 4. The pass complete to Pitts. Has the first down at the 31. Oh, wait a minute. They didn't give. That was a horrible spot. The field goal is good by Cade York, but I can't believe the spot that they gave Pitts. Now Walker with yet another sack. An 8-yard loss on the play, second and 18. Pickett throws it up, and all alone is Godwin. And he has a first down all the way out to the Falcon 45. Back to pass again. This is complete over the middle. Freiermuth has another first down inside the 35. Back to pass again. Pickett throws complete. Snell picks up 4. That is the Steelers' last timeout. So a 45-yard kick, and Gonzalez puts it through. The Steelers take an 8-5 lead into the locker room. A first half safety by each team. And we have a baseball score going into the second half. Atlanta was held to under 60 yards of offense in the first two quarters. Will the correct adjustments be made so we'll see a change as we head into the third? Stay with us to find out, because we'll be right back. Welcome back to Atlanta for second half action between the Steelers and the Falcons. Matt Corral wasn't very accurate in the first half, only hitting on 50% of his passes. Now the question is, can he do better going forward, and can he depend a little more on a running attack that only produced 28 yards in the first half? Well, let's find out as we get the second half underway. The Steelers start out the second half, and with the ball sitting just outside their own 26, Pickett throws, and it's well over the head of his intended target. Back to pass again. Throws the deep ball. He has an open man, and Godwin misses yet another pass. It would seem that Mike Hughes got a hand in there, so that could have been the reason. After another Falcon 3-and-out, Snell takes it out past the 30-yard line for a first down. He surpassed the 50-yard mark, so at least he's on target for a 100-yard game. Freiermuth with the reception on 2nd and 7, and he's held shy of the first down. It's 3rd and 3. Anthony McFarland takes it up the middle for the first down. Now Snell back in there, takes it out to the 49. 2nd and 6. Pickett back to pass, throws complete. Freiermuth has the first down at the 38. And a pass interference call. And the Steelers have it just outside the 35. Snell changing direction, gets it down to the 29. 3rd and 2. Back to pass. Pickett throws it into the end zone and overshoots Deontay Johnson. And on 4th down, they're going for it. Jonathan Abram. Interception. And it looks like he's taking it all the way. Nobody is in a position to stop him. 74-yard pick six. As you can see on the replay, Pickett just didn't have near enough arc on that football, trying to get it to Johnson down the right side, and Abram comes up with the pick six. 12-8, and the Falcons take the lead in the game. That completed to Godwin for a first down, tackled at the 40. And after a false start penalty, it's Smith-Schuster with a 7-yard pickup. Now 3rd and 8. And the jump off to Freiermuth, and he does not get the first down. A yard short, Jaquan Brisker takes him out of bounds. And the punt dies inside the 5-yard line. So the Falcons are going to be starting in a hole again. Corral throws out of the end zone. Pitts with the grab out at the 11. 3rd and 2. Corral can't find anybody open. Finally hits Russell Gage for the first down out past the 25-yard line. They mark him down at the 29. On the 3rd down pass, it's behind Ely and incomplete. So the Steelers take over inside their own 20, and Snell takes it for a 5-yard gain out to the 23. Snell gets the call again, has the first down out past the 30-yard line. Now with just over 2 minutes left in the third quarter. Back to pass, Pickett throws short. Snell has the reception for a 6-yard gain. Now out of the shotgun, McFarland with the carry takes it over the 40-yard line and has the first down. Again, McFarland with another carry, and he takes it out to the 49. 2nd and 4. And they keep McFarland in, and he gets stopped in the backfield. Barnett with the tackle, and it's 12-8. Falcons at the end of 3. 3rd and 5. The pass over the middle, complete to Smith-Schuster. He has the first down at the 41. Inside Falcon territory and down the left side. The pass is complete to Deontay Johnson inside the 20. Pickett back to pass, throws complete. Raider gets a 5-yard pickup. And from the 14, the pass complete in the slot to Johnson. And now they're inside the 5. 1st and goal. The pass almost intercepted. A.J. Terrell just couldn't get a handle on the football. Outside goes McFarland, and he is stopped after a false start penalty. It's third and goal. The pass to Deontay Johnson. That is the third pass that he's caught on that same exact pass pattern. And this time it was in the end zone for a touchdown. The Steelers take the lead in the game, 15-12. The pass complete to Ely on the left side, and he takes it for a 6-yard gain. Another completion to Ely up the left side. He stays in bounds this time and all the way out to the Steeler 47-yard line. Now on 2nd and 10 out of the shotgun. Corral can't find anybody open and goes down in the arms of Trey Flowers for a big loss. So now on 3rd and 22. The pass deep and overshoots everyone. But after a Steeler 3 and out, the Falcons with the ball again. And taken down is Pitts, but not after a 7-yard reception. 2nd and 3, and that is broken up by rookie Colby Harvell-Peel. Ely with another catch. Stops short of the first down by Darius Williams. And Pickett, 39 times in the air, 25 completions for 274 yards. He's throwing for a lot of yards as the Steelers try to maintain this 3-point lead. McFarland dropped for a 1-yard loss. 3rd and 8. Pickett drops back, throwing from the 1, completes the pass, and is swallowed up by the defense. Isaiah Oliver, the first on the scene to make the tackle. 2nd and 10, Corral throws to Allison, and he ducks out of bounds. He could have had a lot more, probably another 10 yards. Pitts with a first down grab over the middle. Corral throws again, and this time Allison is in the middle of the field, and he has the first down at the Steeler 27. Throwing, and Corral completes that one to Kirk for a 9-yard pickup. Inside the red zone now. He completes that one to Love, and he goes all the way down to the 1-yard line before he's pushed out of bounds. 1st and goal. They give it to Love, and he goes untouched into the end zone. The offensive line blows a hole open, and Love takes advantage of that, taking it into the end zone to take the lead away from the Steelers. So with that score, the Falcons take a 19-15 lead here at the end of the fourth quarter. Just over 2 minutes left to play. The pass completed to McFarland for a 2-yard loss. Anthony Walker on the stop. That brings us to the 2-minute warning with the Steelers trying to make a comeback. Pickett all day to throw it. Can't find anybody. Throws short to McFarland, and he is tackled after a couple yard gain. 3rd and 8. The pass over the middle, and it's broken up by Tremaine Edmonds. 4th and 8. The last chance for the Steelers, possibly an out of bounds. Chris Godwin caught it, but he is out of bounds short of the first down. So the ball is taken over by the Falcons at the 32. Ely takes it for a first down. Uh-oh, there is a flag on the play. An illegal block in the back by Christian Kirk, and that means it's first and 8 from just outside the 30. Love loses a yard. We're still going to give him 2nd and 8, and Ely takes it for a couple. So a 3rd and 4. They need to get a first down, and Christian Kirk makes the reception at the 10-yard line, and that should end the football game. The Falcons in the victory formation. Corral takes a knee, and that is all. There is celebration going on the Falcons sideline, and Mike Tomlin is not happy with the result of this football game. The Falcons 19 and the Steelers 15. What a tight football game, but then again, we really didn't expect this one to be a blowout by either team. Probably what seemed to be the most puzzling was the low completion percentage that plagued Corral for the entire game. He was off target a lot, so I don't know if he was being rattled by the Steeler front or he was just a beat off today. Now, given that Kenny Pickett was sacked 8 times today, I would think that he was feeling a little more heat than Matt Corral was. One thing kind of stood out to me was that Kenny Pickett's throwing motion. I knew he had a quick release, but the efficiency with which he could get the ball out of his hands both makes me envious of his ability, yet leaves me scratching my head as to why he got sacked so many times today. The rushing stats are letting us know that the Steeler running game was vastly superior to Atlanta's. That really wasn't a surprise to me, though, especially considering the strength of the Pittsburgh defensive front. What did surprise me was that despite Corral's lower than normal completion percentage, the Steeler defensive backfield gave up yards when the Falcons really needed them. One of the real game changers was that 74-yard pick six by Jonathan Abrams. It would seem that the competition between he and rookie Jaquan Brisker just got stiffer at that strong safety spot. I wonder if there'll be a change come next week. Speaking of next week, Atlanta invites another rookie-led offense into Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Desmond Ridder and the New Orleans Saints try to take down the Falcons. James Cook will be coming off injury next week, so I would expect that he may give the running attack a little boost. After a 40-yard performance this week, the Falcons need some help in that area. The Saints are coming off a 17-14 win over Washington after losing the previous 2 weeks to the Panthers and Broncos. They need to keep that train a-rolling because not only have they lost the top spot in the NFC South, they lost it to these Falcons. It's got to be on their minds that they need to recapture the lead with a win here in Atlanta. Well, that will do it for this episode of the Atlanta Falcons franchise on the MMC Broadcasting Network. With an outstanding come-from-behind win over the Steelers, Atlanta has taken the lead from their next opponent, the New Orleans Saints. Question is, can they stay out in front? New Orleans has been playing some very sloppy football the last 3 weeks. Is next week the game they pull it all together, or will the Falcons be able to slow down the emerging greatness of Ridder and Kamara in the Saints' backfield? To find out, be with us when bitter rivals meet for the lead in the NFC South as the New Orleans Saints come calling on the Falcons in Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Until then, for Eurocat Baby and the rest of the crew, this is Husker Eurocat saying so long for now, and have a good day, everyone.